Hello everyone, let's move on to the next design question. So in the question, we are asked to find the turns per phase, number of stator slots, stator conductors, conductor size and stator slot area of 100 kilowatt, 3 phase, 50 hertz, 400 volt, 1450 rpm, delta connected slip ring induction motor. B average is 0.5 tesla, D is 35 centimeter, L is 30 centimeter, delta is 3.5 ampere per millimeter square, space factor, efficiency, power factor also given. Okay, so we'll proceed. So first we have to find the turns per phase, and we know the turns per phase we will get from the EMF equation, that is equal to E phase divided by 4.44 F phi into kW. So for that we must know the flux per pole, but the flux per pole is not given in the question, so we have to calculate it. So flux per pole will get from the expression for B average. So phi is equal to B average into pi dl divided by number of poles. Number of poles is not given here, so we have to find the number of poles. For that, the rotor speed is given, that is 1450 rpm. Since this is an induction motor, the machine will never run at the synchronous speed. So don't take this as the synchronous speed, this is actually the rotor speed. So we have to find the synchronous speed. The synchronous speed will be the next closest one, which is close to 1450. So we know that it is equal to 120 F divided by number of poles, and number of poles will always be 2, 4, etc. So the next closest synchronous speed is 1500 rpm. So we can take the synchronous speed as 1500 rpm and find the number of poles. Ns is equal to 120 F by P. So we have given Ns is equal to 1500. We'll get the number of poles as 4. Now next is to find the flux per pole. Flux per pole will get it as B average into pi dl by P, that is 0.041 Weber, substituting all the values. Then we can find the turns per phase. Turns per phase is equal to E phase divided by 4.44 Fi into kW. The stator voltage is given, that is 400 volt, and it is said that the machine is delta connected. So VL is equal to V phase. 400, so E phase is 400, so 400 divided by 4.44 Fi into kW. The winding factor is not given in the question, we are assuming it as 0.955 if it is not given. So we will get, so we got the turns per phase as 47. So then total number of conductors will be total number of conductors is per phase it will be 47 into 2, and for all the three phases it will be equal to 47 into 2 into 3. So, or we can write, if we know the turns per phase, then the total number of conductors will be equal to 6 tph. For all the three phases, this is equal to 6 tph. So, we have found the total number of conductors as 282. Now, we have to find the stator slots. So, for that, we can take the guidelines for choosing the number of stator slots. So, the first guideline is the stator slot pitch should be between 15 millimeter and 25 millimeter. That means the stator slot pitch is pi d divided by number of stator slots. So from that we'll get the number of stator slots should lie between pi d by 15 mm and pi d by 25 mm. So we can substitute the value of d over here. So we got that the stator slots should lie between 44 and 73. Now next we'll apply the second guideline, that is the slots per pole per phase should be an integer. So we are starting from 2. So we are taking values 2, 3, 4, etc. and finding the number of stator slots. So if the slots per pole per phase is 2, the number of stator slots will be equal to slots per pole per phase is 2. So 2 into number of phases 3 into 3 into number of poles is 4. So we'll get the number of slots, that is equal to 24. If it is 3, then it will be equal to 3 into number of phase, that is equal to 3 into number of poles is equal to 4, that is equal to 36. Similarly for 4 also we'll get it as 48. So from the first guideline we got that the stator slots should lie between 44 and 73. And now from the second guideline, the value which satisfies this limit is 48. So we are going to choose the number of stator slots as 48. So select the number of slots as 48. So we'll get the we can find the conductors per slot. So earlier we have found the total number of conductors, that is 282, and now we got the number of slots as 48. So we can find the conductors per slot, that is equal to, we'll get it as approximately 5.87. So we are approximating it to the nearest integer, so that is 6. So since it is, we got this as a fraction, the number of conductors will be different here. So we'll find the total number of conductors again. So that will be equal to 6 into number of slots, that is 48. So the total number of conductors has increased from 282. Here it becomes 288. So the total number of conductors is 288. Now we have to find the conductor area and stator slot area. Conductor area or conductor cross section is equal to I phase divided by delta. I phase is the current flowing through each conductor and delta is the current density. So delta is given in the question. We have to find I phase. So in order to find I phase, we can use the input KVA. We know that input KVA Q is equal to 3 E phase into I phase. So Q is not given in the question. The output is given, that is 10 kilowatt. From that we can find the input KVA. So Q is equal to kilowatt divided by efficiency into power factor. That is the input KVA. So 3 V phase I phase cos phi is the input. So output divided by efficiency gives the input. So input is equal to output divided by efficiency into power factor. So we will get Q as Kw divided by efficiency into power factor, that is equal to 133.7 kVA. So once we find Q, we can find the I phase. So I phase is equal to Q divided by 3 E phase. Q is 133.7 kVA. So 133.7 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 3 into E phase, that is 400. So we got the phase current as 111.42 ampere. Now we can find the conductor area. So conductor area is equal to I phase divided by delta. Delta is 3.5 ampere per millimeter square. So I have substituted the value and we have got the conductor cross section as 31.83 millimeter square. Now next thing is we have to find the stator slot area or the total area. So that is that we will obtain from this expression. So that is space factor is equal to copper area divided by total area. So we have to find the copper area in each slot. So we know that the conductor area is 31.83 millimeter square, that is the area of one conductor, and in each slot there are 6 conductors. So total copper area in each slot will be equal to 31.83 into 6. So we have got the copper area, and the space factor is given in the question as 0.4. If it is not given also, we'll assume it as 0.4, but it is given in the question. So we know the space factor and we know the copper area. Then we can find the total area of the slot or the stator slot area, which is equal to copper area per slot divided by space factor. So we'll get it as 477 millimeter square. So that finishes the design.